아이 나야 nga chu wo jin nang tong ge de ni ta ne kup ge ni cher ge lor ji wang de she na a pe na a lor chik chi wa dong a ta den chi wa ti ne kup na de ni ta lor ji lan ge ro chen bon ri ti yo ge ge ro chen bon ri shong yo re de shong de nga chu wo ge kwe ba mong bo zu de ni ji ge shi shu ge sa cha a ta ja ge ri amerika re de jin de na ta yorup ku shogre tene sacha moz gan rod ge tge songje tene khung namba chu yin na ta ti sta bi ni chur ge gu gdo ga sa mon bu myo yin na tarun shlo jung ge jin ma mer chir ge da na tene ji chu la tene tene jamba ge ji mer ge jamba ta na jer ke jamba ge mo chu la kala kan sam ge phan thog ju ya ga te tene ma chek in jik ten ge hui zi ga jing en zhuk si jir zi ji zi gong zhe ta tu cun zha wab zheng ge na dang sang ji ge sa cha da ri ge dan zambo lang ge sa cha su su na yang ji ge chulik ge lop zha gong ba de zhen de chu zhuk ta di mo mong bo zi ge ya ra zi ge tab ge da na di ni ji ge nup shuk da na khar shuk ge yang mo mong bo zi ge di ni na wo ji nang teng ge chulik de cho yin na kong nan bi Jilun Shonje Dana, Flujun Shiji, Kurkuyan has a Yawzga Tonyoje.
In the '50s and sixties, due to the changing circumstances in the Chinese culture, which was also affecting life in Tibet at that time, many of the great scholars and masters of the Tibetan tradition, as you know, were forced to become refugees in Western countries, first going out, spilling out into India, and eventually making their way out into Western continents, America, Europe, and so forth. And although they underwent many difficulties during this changing time, for the most part, these masters never lost their enthusiasm or their spiritual training or their commitment to be of benefit to humanity. In whatever way was deemed necessary. And so it became what we say, there's a well-known proverb in Tibetan, adversity to the path. Adversity becomes the path of practice. It became this kind of an experience for them, that they turned it into a positive circumstance, which then enhances their capacity even more. And therefore, they were able to establish Dharma centers, as they're referred to, or monasteries, or scholastic colleges, places to learn and practice the Buddhist tradition around the world. And so that process began and has continued to the present day, not only just in Western countries, but also in Eastern countries, giving people around the world an opportunity to learn and practice Tibetan Buddhism.
Tar kap te na nga chu nang lo na yo ni po yer kum kheba cho yin na chi gu ngo sir ge lo jong shi ji dan na lo chi shi ji ge kur ke yang chi ge ya ha zu yo na ma re re ta na te ni kheba mong bo zu ge korong zu gin de ta lo jong shi ji o te ta cham ji yo na ma re pe na nga rang ge ger gen tenin khambon jigme phon zo khong zhe zin jang na ta lo parchir lo ni shi er mer zga ranga tenin shu chu gu lo jong shi ki ge ji gun ba dan de jin de lop cha la su ba ge ji tab de bo yo ma re ta yin na yang chu zho le jang le le ka kang dang kang shi ne nan zha ta hui nam zho le yin na zi ge zho ra zi ge yo yi qi rong di da ta khong ge ni zir na yo ni tenin ta mambo zga chuchu tu shat nare pe na nima gara ina tene ji sa phu ge na ina ja ja phu ge na ina mane tari shang wo ta nak sir ta nimu ge na ge ne na ta ge mang gare ge so wa ge ge mang gare tene nyam de lo jong shi na no jong mambo zga de tene lo jong shi tene cham mo ne ke na ya jo me ge go ta na tene tari nyam de lo jong shi ge da na lo chi shi ge da ta ne jin ma chi pa song je de ji ma ta lor ge chi bi ne kem na te ni ji chul xsar ge ji chab jog shi ge ge ko ko shong ge ron di ta ngo chu yin na de ge da ka sno de ren ge da ni kong ge song ge re la rong gar ndo chu yin na te ni xsar de mer na xur chung shi mer gu ne ge And simultaneously,
while this was happening, then within Tibet, the opportunity was not so great, as of course you can imagine, but there were many scholars and dedicated practitioners who were left behind, who actually never gave up their studies either during all these years when Dharma was not permitted to be practiced or studied in an open way at all. And so, for example, my teacher, Kempo Jigpun Rinpoche, he would actively teach two disciples to about some 20 of these great masters who were his disciples, and would continue to teach and train them in secrecy. They were all shepherds, and so they would go out in the guise of herding the animals, and when no one was looking, for example, they would then cloister and go into caves or into the woods, and he would continue to teach them and instruct them in a hidden way. And then they would go off, even if they had jobs during the day where they had to go and work for the Chinese government, they would go back home at night, or if they were farmers, they would go back home or to wherever they were staying at night. And under the light of a candle or an incense burning, they would secretly study the material that he had taught them in the day. And so this went on in as a process of the continuity of their education up until the 1980s, when once again things became more flexible and they were allowed to congregate and begin to study Dharma in a more open fashion. And it was right around that time, as it was mentioned, that this Larungar, this great monastic institution for the five sciences, founded by my teacher, Kempo Jigpun Rinpoche, was instigated. And he already had the trainees, the educators, who were these masters who had been studying under him for all those years. And so there was no need to retrain new educators. The process was already in place, and they were ready to begin.
Lord Namagno nga sanjer was ga jawab ko nre ta larung gar ko tni tansam khambo mo ndus tni larung gar ko churjin da tartar janag na hajang chig tarchep chimbo nre songak ndur jirchin kang la tni insa ko se tang et zenin ta ti zu tari ga shonar jirchin mo zu yo re ta tin nang ga yang zu tari khwerna tam khambo jingme phan song zu na Lord,
Last year, one news reporter asked me, there are so many of these scholars, these Kempos, it means abbots, great scholars who are present in this monastic institution. And not only that, Tibetan Buddhism is spreading so widely around China due to their efforts. How is it that you were able to train so many scholars to become such excellent educators in this way? And I responded that, well, generally speaking, then the main reason for this is because of the efforts of my teacher, Kenpo Jigpun Rinpoche, who for some 20 years, when there was no permission to engage in religious study or practice, he privately continued to teach and train disciples. And so that's a long period of time for those disciples to be continuing their efforts in education in secrecy. And it's for that reason that later on, when things opened up, they were already in a position to be learned and to take on their own students and to continue this process on a grand scale. And so that's why it has spread out into the world and, of course, closely there in the proximity of China. And so the point that we look at, which allows for this to be possible, is this capacity to be confident and to be dedicated, which is very much like the founding fathers of the United States, from what I've been able to read and learn. There are the human qualities of being heroic, being enthusiastic about education and about the betterment of humanity. And if each individual can take on these kinds of commitments, then imagine what a better world we'd be able to live in. Because those masters were studying under in a secret environment at the cost of their life. But yet they never gave up. And that's the same premise that this country was founded upon and so forth. And so to be able to have that level of confidence and commitment in order to improve the world, not only just oneself, but to be of benefit to everyone, I think this is a crucial point that we all need to begin to emphasize even more.